Hello and welcome to this session in which we would learn about the concept of lower of cost or net realizable value. So we would report our inventory at lower of cost or net realizable value rather than the historical cost. And basically this is a deviation from the historical cost. Historical cost is how much we paid for that item. Well, the question is why? There are two reasons why we do so. The first one is being conservative. In accounting, if we have overstated inventory, we cannot report it at an overstated amount. We have to reduce the cost of that inventory. Why? Because the inventory lost utility. Somehow the inventory is not as valuable as it was when we originally purchased it. It could be for many reasons. It could be technology changes. It could be market demand. For some reason, the asset lost utility. For example, if you have oil, and oil prices go down, well, if you purchase them already, your inventory cost is now your inventory valued at lower than the cost because it's you purchased them at $60. Now each barrel of oil is $50. Well, it lost utility, $10 of utility. The other reason is record your losses earlier. So don't wait until you sell your inventory. If you know that your inventory lost value, guess what? Don't wait until you sell it because you may not sell it until a year from now or 2 years from now. You want to record the loss in the year that inventory took place. Also, what's that going to do? It's going to spread your losses rather than having losses all at once. And this way we'll give a picture of what's going on in your company as time goes by, rather than selling this item 2 years later and you have a large loss that investors, creditors are not aware of. So those are the two reasons why we need to learn about lower of cost or net realizable value. This topic is covered in intermediate accounting as well as the CPA exam. Whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition to your CPA review course. I explain the material differently than your CPA review course. I provide you alternative resources, alternative explanation, alternative multiple choice questions, alternative exercises that's going to help you understand your CPA review course better. Your risk is 1 month of subscription. Give it a try. If you find it's helping you, you keep it. Otherwise, you cancel. Your potential gain is passing the exam. If not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well or not well your university doing on the CPA exam. I do have resources for other accounting courses, lectures, multiple choice, such as advanced accounting, managerial accounting, auditing. I also have all the previously AI CPA released questions, almost 1,500 of those questions with detailed solution. My CPA review courses, CPA supplemental review courses, are aligned with your Becker, Wiley, Roger, and Gleam. This way you can go back and forth between my material and your CPA review course. If you have not connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation, like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So the first thing we want to know is what is net realizable value? Because we have to choose between our cost, which is we know what our cost is, and something called net realizable value or NRV. NRV is computed by taking the estimated selling price in the ordinary course of business. It means it's not a fire sale. You're not selling it at a discount because you need to get rid of it. It's the normal selling price, which is the selling price, minus reasonably predicted cost to sell. So what are some reasonably predicted costs to sell? Well, you might incur sales commission. You might incur transportation out, freight out. You might incur some packaging or some other cost. The best way to illustrate this is to look at an example. Adam purchases an item for $950. It has a sales value today of $1,000. Estimated cost to complete the sale is $50, and the estimated selling price is $200. Well, let's take a look at how we would compute NRV. The selling price is $1,000. This is the estimated selling price minus predictable cost to sell. Well, estimated cost to complete the sale is $50. Estimated cost to sell is $250. We have another $250 to sell it. Therefore, what we're going to be getting for this item if we sell it is $750. The cost of this item is, guess what, $950. We are at a loss of $200. So what we have to do, we have to report this $750 in the inventory, and we have to report a loss in the income statement of $200. dollars. The best way to illustrate this concept a little bit further is to look at an example. So we're going to be assuming we sell fruits and we have apples and pears, and we have different type of apples and different type of pears, and we're going to look at their cost, their net realizable value, and we're going to have to choose between the two and look at the journal entry. So the first thing is we are selling apples. The red are apples, Gala, Macintosh, Granny Smith, Golden, Red Delicious, and we have Asian pear, European pear, and gold pear. This is how many pounds we have right now. This is how much we paid for each pound, right? And this is how much the net realizable value, if we want to sell those pounds, how much can we sell it per pound? 85 cents, 75 cents, 20 cents, 60 cents, you know, the Red Delicious, we can't get anything, barely a cent for it. Okay, now we're going to compute total cost, and basically total cost is how many pounds we have times the cost of the pear, which is $600. The Macintosh, the same thing. Now we're going to compute the total net realizable value. We are giving the net realizable value per pound. We'll just take 800 times 85 cents. We'll give us 680, and we'll compute the net realizable value for all. Now we have total cost, and by the way, this is the total cost. So ignore the red because the total for the apple, and the green is the total for the pear. So what we're going to do, I'm going to add all the individuals. I'm adding all the individual total cost here, all the individual total cost here, and they add up to $5,605. I'm going to do the same thing for the total net realizable value. And what I have to do is I already computed the net realizable value. Notice this is the total and this is the total. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to compare the total cost to the net realizable value, and I find out I have a difference when I look at my inventory overall of $119. So that's one way to compute the difference. So what does that mean? It means you have to write down your inventory by $119. So I looked at the total inventory. Another way to do so is to select the, rather than selecting the whole inventory, I'm going to be selecting each item and finding out the lower of cost or net realizable value. Well, what does that mean? It means I'm going to look at the 600 versus the 680, and I'm going to choose the 600 as my reported inventory. I'm going to look at 360 for the Macintosh versus 450. Well, I'm going to choose the 360 because 360 is lower. For the Granny Smith, I'm going to look at 225 cost, net realizable value 90. I'm going to choose the 90, the lower. Golden, 240 versus 180. I will choose the lower. Red Delicious, they're basically, we have to get rid of them. 390 versus $6, the $6. And I will do the same thing for the pears. I will choose each individual item. So here what I'm looking at each item separately. And what I find out, my lower of cost or net realizable value per item is 4,996. My cost is 5,605. I have a utility loss of 609. I have a difference of 609. Or what I can do, rather than looking at the whole inventory, or rather than looking at each item, I can value my inventory by categories. I can take a look at the total cost for all the apples, the net realizable value for all the apples, and choose the lower of the two, which is 1,406. I can do the same thing for the pears. Add up all the pears, add up all the pears at the net realizable value, and choose between the lower, between the cost and the net realizable value. The 3790 cost is lower than net realizable value. This is what I would report. And I will add them up, and the difference between those is $409. So now the question is, which one would I report? You could report any loss you would like to, but the most conservative one is when you compute them per item. You compute them per item. And this is what we're going to do. We're going to look at we're going to be reporting the lower of cost or net realizable value per each item, which is going to give us $609 of losses. Now we need to book the loss. Well, there are two methods to book the loss. There is the loss method, which we will debit a loss. It's called the loss method due to decline in inventory to NRV of $609. And we will credit allowance to reduce inventory 609. Or we could use the cost of goods sold method, which is debiting cost of goods sold directly 609 and crediting inventory 609. So what's going to happen is this: the loss due to decline in inventory, it's going to be close to cost of goods sold anyway. But there are the two methods, just in case your textbook or your CPA review course use a different method. And again, we can credit inventory directly, or we can credit allowance. The allowance would reduce inventory. Now, it doesn't make a difference which method you use on the financial statements, because if you use the allowance method rather than reducing inventory, for example, here we have 40,000 of inventory, then you would reduce the inventory by 609. When we add up our current assets, they will add up to 94,392. If you reduce inventory directly rather than reporting inventory at 40,000, you would reduce it directly by 609. Your total current assets will be the same, because you are reducing inventory directly rather than indirectly. Also, on the income statement, it doesn't make a difference, because whether you debited cost of goods sold directly under the cost of goods sold method, or if you debited loss, then close the loss into cost of goods sold, the 609 will eventually reduce the increase the cost of goods sold by 609, which is we end up in the same place. So we end up, whether we are using the loss or the cost of goods sold method, the effect on income should be the same, and the effect on the balance sheet should be the same. That's the point I'm trying to make here, whether you use the loss or the cost of goods sold method. Now, if you use the loss method, you're going to have to worry about the allowance. And this is the point that we're trying to make. The allowance is a contra asset account, and you have to keep it. Contra asset account stays with you from year to year. For example, if we have this data, and we have inventory at cost of 200,000, net realizable value is 188. It means we have a loss of 12,000. That's the required valuation, because we have to reduce our inventory by 12,000. So we have to have a valuation account, which is allowance to reduce inventory, to be more specific, to reduce inventory, and we have to have in there 12,000. And what we do is we debit loss due to decline in inventory and credit allowance to reduce inventory. Now we reduce our inventory in year one by 12,000. In year two, December 31st, X2, our inventory is 190,000. Our inventory at NRV is 183. Now the difference is 7,000. This is an allowance account. Simply put, we have to have in our allowance account 7,000 rather than 12,000. What does that mean? It means we have to reduce our allowance by 5. Let me choose a different color here. By 5,000. Okay? The adjustment is a decrease in our allowance, and the effect on income, it's going to be an increase. Although we have a losses of 7,000, but relative to the prior year, we improve by 5,000. Therefore, we debit allowance to reduce inventory, to reduce this account, to reduce this balance by 5, and we have some sort of a gain or a revenue. So simply put, on a timeline, okay, this is zero, okay, and we're always working on the negative end. Let me put this timeline down here. So on a timeline, it looks something like this. This is the zero valuation. And we started at 12,000. We had $12,000 of negative valuation. Now we are at 7,000. So we move to the right $5,000. Okay, every time we move to the right, it's a positive. In 20X3, the cost and the NRV were equal to each other. Well, what does that mean? Well, that's good, because now our valuation should be zero. For valuation to be zero, we have to debit allowance an additional 7,000. It means now we're going to move from negative 7,000 to zero, so we're moving to the right another 7,000, okay? So again, we debit allowance, credit some sort of a gain. In year four, the cost is 282. The NRV is 280. It means we need to go back. We can go above zero, obviously. Now we need to go back to negative 2,000. Therefore, we have to increase the allowance by 2,000, and the income obviously will decrease, because when we increase the allowance, we book a loss of 2,000. Okay, so the point I'm trying to make is the allowance don't go away. Now, in the real world, it might go away, but But for CPA purposes, for your class purposes, the allowance account will stay with you from year to year, and it's a contra asset. Therefore, you need to know how to adjust it from year to year. Remember, the allowance account could go up to zero. That's it, because even if your net realizable value is higher than your cost, you cannot book a gain. You report it at cost. So you're always working below zero. Basically, the allowance is reducing your inventory. That's what I mean below zero. It means you have losses to book. At the end of this recording, I'm going to remind you, whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. Keep it. I'm a useful addition to your CPA review course. You study for your exam once in your lifetime. Give it all what you got. Don't shortchange yourself. Invest in yourself. Put the CPA exam behind you. It's worth it. Good luck. Study hard and stay safe.